I guess we can get cracking to the questions.
Yeah, so we may ask all of
that. Every advocate has their own secret weapons.
An important part of it is knowing who your audience is.
Yeah.
So some judges may be quite interventionist, whereas some judges prefer to let you develop your own case as you go along. So I find it useful to know if the judge I'm appearing before is either one of these so that I can tailor my style accordingly.
The one thing that I've learned over the years is that one or two points, normally that wins you or lose you your case. I think when I first started, you wanted to make every single point that you thought was good.
Yeah.
But ultimately, it does seem like, you know, cases turn on those big major points. So I found being prepared makes all the difference. You know, if you know your documents at the back of your hand, judge says, you know, there's this document. I say, oh, I think that's in the grid bundle, volume 12. You know, the judge starts to think, this guy knows his case.
Yeah.
I mean, and I can trust that, you know, he's gone through the material. What drives you to do criminal advocacy?
Every accused person deserves the right to full and vigorous representation. For accused persons in particular, being put into the criminal justice system can be quite dehumanizing. I mean, if you think a civil litigant feels stressed out, I mean, imagine what an accused person feels like when he has a jail term or even a lengthy fine hanging over his head. I think you did a high court criminal trial that went all the way up to the Court of Appeal. So
yeah.
How was that like?
It was the first high court trial that I did.
Mm.
So even before I did my first civil trial, I did my first criminal trial pro bono. I would say it's memorable because it's so different and where you don't have all the documents that you're used to. So what I found, and this is maybe my tip for young advocates, is that you've got to be expansive in your questioning. Even if you have a condition statement, it's usually short, it's 2 or 3 pages. Mm-hmm. And you need to really probe every aspect of the incident. I'm gonna ask you, you know, you are obviously the second winner of the Joseph Grimberg Outstanding Young Advocate Award. How has the winning the award changed your career?
It did raise my profile within the firm, and it's given my bosses and my clients more confidence to entrust me with major pieces of work or to have more autonomy in running my cases. Lionel, as the inaugural winner of the Joseph Grimberg Prize, do you have any helpful points you'd like to tell to potential applicants?
I'll tell them all the same tips I told you.
Oh yes,
before
yes,
you won the award. But no, actually I can't remember what I told you. But firstly, I think obviously highlighting your involvement in important cases. What role did you play? So obviously what I did was to highlight the cases where I was lead counsel, where I conducted the cross-examination, I did the appellate advocacy. I think that's probably more important than having done a $500 million arbitration, but you were the fifth chair.
Yes.